So I have to measure on the time for myself as well. So what I would like to talk about is not completely only my work, because it is based on something that Miklos has done recently. And that is that great thing that he removed the use of XSLT in the writer filter code generation. As you might know, writer filter works that way that we have the description of like what is supposed to be as the tokens when parsing OXML, and we have this description in model XML, and there used to be code in XSLT that produced code that was later compiled. And this compiled code was actually tokenizing all this thing during parsing over XML. And like when it was in XSLT, nobody had the courage to actually touch it. But then Miklos decided to change it to Python. And at some stage, I had some time for hacking, and I looked at the results of the code generation, and I was surprised like how ugly it looks, and it was completely unreadable. So I said, okay, well, I have half an hour of time, so I will just fix it in Python so that it aligns nicely and you can actually read the code. And it turned out that after I was able to read the code, well, this was because Miklos did it one-to-one conversion from the XSLT to Python, so the result was completely the same as before in the XSLT. So after we had it in Python, I was able to change it so that the code was actually readable, and it struck me how terrible it is, because it was using boost unordered maps to store all the things that you were supposed to tokenize, and like with every time you started to do something with writer filter, you actually had to create these unordered maps, and then you were able to use them. So it was not optimized by the compiler at all. All it was relying on was that the boost unordered map might be fast enough to actually look up the strings or the IDs inside. So then, when I found another free time to do something, I started with one of the methods that was there and converted it from like filling in the boost unordered map into just a normal switch. Just a normal switch with cases that are used now. And when I did one, well, it was easy, so I did another and another. And finally, we have everything like changed from this boost unordered map to using just normal compiled switches and cases. And the results are great because we have saved something like 2 megabytes of code just by switching it to compiled code, and also like the compiler can do some funny stuff there, like do a search tree on the switches and cases and stuff like that. So writer filter is now much more readable again. And I hope that we will reach a state that it will be understandable as a whole. So thank you a lot. So next is Jan Marek again. And he will tell us what you will tell us.
So. Yeah. So